Hello guys, welcome to a new video where I'm gonna show how to build a backend website with Spring Boot. Today, I will talk about tests. Not the unit tests, but the integration tests. For that, I will use JUnit5, Mockito and H2 with DBUnit. Ready to enter in the world of the tests? Remember to subscribe to my channel and let's go! In fact, I should have done this video about the test earlier, because the test must go with the development, not at the end of the project. But now I have all the main parts of the project done, the injected services and the database, so I can show how to test both parts at once. The topic is too large to be in a single video, so I split it in two videos. This one will contain the configuration and the tests in the services, and the second part will contain the tests on the controllers and the database. I will start preparing the project to accept JUnit5 tests, Spring tests and Mockito. For that, I will add the dependencies in the POM XML. For the Spring Boot starter test, I must add some exclusions to avoid conflicts with JUnit5. Okay, I have controllers, I have mappers, repositories, and services to test. I will start by the easiest one, the mappers. This annotation means that this static method will be executed before all the tests. This will initialize the mapper before starting the tests. This must be done before running the first test. I used to split the tests in three parts: given, when, and then. In the given part, I initialize the values, the input parameters, and the state of the system. In the when part, I call the methods to be tested. And in the then part, I check the results, I add the assertions. I use the fluid mode of Lombok to build the object. Let's run this test. I hope it is green. Yes, I won't add more tests now, but you will find more in the Git repository. Let's see another mapper, the message mapper, which has a dependency to the user mapper. This time, I will use the beforeAll method to inject the dependency, to inject the user mapper inside the message mapper. For that, I will use the reflection. Okay, let's now continue with the next level. Let's continue with the services. The difference now is that I have Spring, which injects me services or repositories inside the service I want to test. I will work with the user service, which has the user repository, a password encoder, and a mapper injected by Spring. The first thing I will need to add is the Mockito extension. Before JUnit 5, it was called the runners. This will help me to inject the mocks or spies in the service. This one is the service which receives the mocks. The mocks are services which are empty, which are dummy. They have no behavior. I must specify each action for them. And the spies are services which will be injected but maintain their original behavior. And I can also check, I can also verify the call they receive. This way, I specify the behavior of the repository when the input parameter is 10. And I can verify that a mock or a spy was called with the given arguments. Great! I will end this video now and continue in the second part with the tests on the controllers and the tests against the database. But remember that the test must be written while writing the application, not once the application is finished. The tests are the quickest way to validate the behavior of the application. It's the quickest way to know if an application works as expected. Don't test in production, write your tests! Subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on the like button if you enjoyed the video. And see you in the second part of this topic. Bye!